Hello. Let's talk all things fall. Can you say cooler weather, gorgeous foliage, and pumpkin spice everything? Now we're talking. I'm ready for fall. I love spring and summer, but I think fall has my heart. And if you're a fall girl also, then you're going to love today's post because we're talking all things fall essentials. This is a comprehensive list, and this should help you be styling like a fashionista this coming fall. Hi, I'm Tanya from 50 is Not Old, and welcome to my channel. I'm here to help you look modern and stylish and to feel more confident in your fashion choices. Be sure to subscribe, and you should see lots more tips on beauty and hairstyles as well as fashion. So let's talk fall. Let's get started. A lot of essential items might not be items that you necessarily like to wear. So my best advice for any time of the year is to pick and choose what works best for you and keep the rest in the back of your mind. Just keep an open mind, try it, and make sure that it works for you now, even though it didn't before. So these rules or must-haves are not in concrete. As I said, experiment. Fashion should be fun, not stressful. So here's my top 10. Number one, cardigans and sweaters. If you're someone like me who's always cold, cardigans and sweaters are my must-have when it comes to fall weather. Actually, I pretty much wear cardigans all year round, but fall is my favorite time to throw them on, and I do wear them with almost everything. I use cardigans for warmth and style, but also use them to create some curves. I don't have a defined waistline, so a cardigan tricks the brain into thinking I'm thinner than I actually am. So there's lots of styles of cardigans and sweaters, and depending on your body style and your height, you can choose what works best for you. Some like long cardigans, some like the shorter or cropped cardigans, and that cropped style is trending everywhere, so you have to find out what works best for you. The cropped is not necessarily my best look. I do love softness though, and I look for that, and Barefoot Dreams and anything cashmere is something I look for. You may not be able to wear cashmere, so you wear what works best for you. Now, I love turtlenecks or cowlnecks, and even though I have a round face and more chins than I want to admit, a turtleneck is not probably my best look, but I still love them. Instead, I try to go with a V-neck, such as I have on today, but I'm not going to throw turtlenecks completely out of my wardrobe. I'll wear them occasionally, but cowlnecks work better because they are bigger, longer, draw the eye downward, and so I will wear those more than a turtleneck. This is where it helps to experiment when it comes to fashion. My second choice is jeans. Everybody loves jeans. Well, I said everybody. I love jeans. I hope you do too. But anyway, there's lots and lots and lots of styles and choices and even different washes that you can choose from. Once again, try to find something that works for your body style. More days than not, you will find me reaching for a pair of jeans. And I have a wide variety of jeans. I have all different styles and all different color washes. So right now, everything trending is the straight leg or the relaxed jeans, and they're definitely having their moment. So try those if you want to look more young, relevant, modern looking, because they're extremely popular. But I've seen a lot of the cropped leg styles and flare jeans, and don't forget the skinnies, because they still have a place in your wardrobe. And I feel like you'll see more of them this fall and winter because of ankle booties and knee boots. However, remember to look modern and fresh looking. Mix it up, try a little bit of all, and try all the current fashions. Number three, non-jeans. not mom jeans, but non-jeans. So just because I love wearing my jeans doesn't mean that that fits into your lifestyle. I don't work from home. I mean, I work from home, so I don't have to dress up, but those who are still working may need to wear dressier pants, and those who are staying home may want more of a relaxed lounging wear. Try it and see what works. I love a ponte knit, and they are tight and they fit great. I have a pair of Spanx, which I love, 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 but there's more out there than Spanx. You can try them. I have some recently purchased, and they were almost identical, but just not quite as expensive. Now, I also love wide jeans, wide pants. When you're wearing a wide pant, just remember to wear something tighter on the top with your wide pants. Now, I don't own a ton of dress pants. Just as I said, I don't work outside the home anymore, so I don't have as many of those, but I do have chinos and twills, and you can dress those up really nice. Number four, dresses. Speaking of dressing up, so most of us need a couple, at least a couple of dresses in our closet. Florals are trending this year, and I love wearing a style, that style of dress for fall, because you can add booties and knee boots. Just as the weather gets cooler, you decide. Now, I also love animal prints, and you can find leopard, cheetah, zebra, and snakeskin in dresses and skirts, and those look fabulous with boots. I like a midi-length dress, especially in the fall, and I love pairing them with the long cashmere cardigans and boots, but you experiment for what length works best for you. Either way, I do think you need to have at least two dresses in your closet for just in case the need arises. And since we're talking about boots and booties, number five. So ankle boots is what I wear most in the fall, and the styles are constantly changing. Right now, I'm loving the platform and the lug boots. And so depending on what you like, I wear a lot of high heels. But if you're not into high heels, you can do the riding boots, the flats. If your area is got lots of snow, then you're going to want something more like the Sorrel, waterproof, or even those warm UGG boots. So experiment, seems to be my favorite word, and see what works for you. I do think knee boots are going to still be strong this year, although I don't think over the knee or the thigh high version is going to be very popular, but you never know. And as I said, if it's in a rainy season or cold season, you can still get those hunter boots or waterproof boots. But we all need a base layer. And when it's in the cold climate, such as where my daughter lives in Alaska, you learn to do a lot of layering. So number six is base layers. You start with something lightweight, long sleeve, a wicking top, and then you add layers on top of that. Where it doesn't get as cold where I live, I don't have to do a whole lot of layering. My layering can be just a camisole and a t-shirt, and then I can just throw on a denim jacket or something like that. Especially when fall first begins, I don't need to have anything quite as heavy, so a sweater works fine. But as the temperatures start to plunge, you might need to wear something just a little more substantial than a turtleneck and a long sleeve t-shirt. So a sweater or even the heavier materials will work, and then start building on top of that. Number seven is scarves. So I know scarves are probably not the trendiest thing at the moment, but let me tell you, you can't beat a scarf in fall. They're great for adding color to any outfit, and they also serve a purpose. A blanket scarf is wonderful for keeping your neck and your chest warm, and you can even drop them over your shoulders when you're in a chilly restaurant. I don't know why restaurants make everything so cold. Anyway, let's go on. Number eight, jackets. So right behind my love for cardigans and sweaters is my love for jackets. I love wearing denim jacket in the fall, and everyone needs at least one of these extremely versatile jackets. I wear my denim jacket all year round, and especially great for fall. And a moto or motorcycle jacket is another great jacket for fall. I love this jacket. I think it makes you look 10 years younger. You automatically look more modern, more relevant when you put on a moto jacket. Let's face it, what's not to love? So I have several moto jackets. Some are in leather, some are in suede, some are in faux leather, and they all look great in fall. And you can wear them with pants, you can wear them with dresses, leggings, jeans, etc. Number 9, we're flying through these, flats and sneakers. So I have a lot of readers who tell me they can't wear heels, so flats and sneakers are the best option for them. And thankfully, brands are starting to give us more fashionable choices in flats and sneakers, and we no longer have to leave out the style factor. I don't wear a lot of running shoes. I don't do a lot of running, but I do love fashionable sneakers, and those speak my love language. Speaking of love language, number 10, handbags. So a handbag is one area that I will definitely splurge in, but I love all different styles and colors. But if you want to, you can get by with carrying just one handbag all year round. If that's the case, then you need to choose a good neutral one, a color that will go with anything. I prefer taupe or a beige. I think that works with any season. But other neutrals that you might want to consider are black, gray, navy, or burgundy. Black's a little harsh, but I love a black bag with black jeans or a black moto jacket, and I have handbags in almost all those colors. My favorite is the taupe. My least favorite is the gray. But I don't have many gray shoes either, and I have a ton of taupe shoes, so that must just be my favorite color. I'm gonna give you a bonus. I said 10, but let's have one more bonus, and that is coats or outerwear. So coats is another thing that climate dictates. In other words, if you live in the cold climates, you want the Thinsulate or the puffer coats. While I go toward a lightweight coat, and it's been, you know, well before freezing, before I even put on a coat, I use sweaters, cardigans, and jackets to keep me warm. However, I do love a really nice wool cashmere coat so I can put it on when we're going somewhere where I need to be a little more dressy and stay warm. Well, I probably left out a few things, but I think this list will keep you at least warm, cozy, modern, stylish, and I hope you will look like a fashionista this fall. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe and share it with your friends. I appreciate it. Goodbye.